Hey everyone, it's Ashley. Welcome back to my channel. Today I am back with another large die of the month from Spellbinders. If you aren't familiar with their club kits, you can go into my description and there are links to more information. So at first, I'm going to set out all of the dies that you get in this month's kit, as I usually do, and let you know what they do. So this first one here actually makes the card for you, and the very top doesn't actually cut, it is a scoring piece. So it will cut out three sides and then score the very top so that you get this piece of cardstock like I have here, only it opens. So you get the actual shape for the card base, which is really nice. And you don't have to do any thinking when it comes to the card front because you can just go ahead and die cut that out again. And then I just use an X-Acto knife to cut the very top where that score line is, but you could use a paper trimmer or scissors as well. And then that smaller piece there is the sort of piece of paper looking thing that is supposed to go all together at the end when this looks like a clipboard. It's supposed to look like the paper that's on the clipboard. So then we have these three pieces here, and this will actually make the clipboard mechanism that goes on the very top. And this will actually end up opening and shutting like a real clipboard. Obviously, it doesn't hold any weight, much at all, if any, honestly, but it does do the opening and closing. So this bottom piece here has two score lines, and you'll fold these up together so that it's sort of like a hot dog fold is how I used to call it. And then when you go ahead and tape all of the elements together, you'll get the mechanism that goes at the very top of the clipboard. Now I'm using scoring tape instead of glue for a few reasons. One, because I think it's just going to hold a little bit better, and two, because I don't have to wait as long for this to dry. I used metallic gold cardstock for this mechanism because usually these parts of clipboards are metallic and shiny, so I wanted to make sure that that came through in my actual end result. And in my experience, glue on metallic cardstock or mirror cardstock just doesn't dry very quickly, and I just didn't want to have to wait. So I used tape, scoring tape, and it worked just fine. So moving on, we have the accoutrement pieces here. So these two will make a paper clip, as you can see here, and these paper clips look extremely realistic. And then the other pieces will make a pencil together. There's actually a piece that I'm putting down right now actually goes to the pen die that you can put all together. This die here also cuts out the rest of the pen. So this piece here is the bottom. This pattern piece of cardstock that I used is for the cap. And then we've got two other pieces that I used with metallic cardstock again, and these are just sort of like the embellishment pieces that are on the pen. There's another small die here that cuts out the eraser and then both pieces of the actual lead portion of the pencil. So you've got one sort of blunt portion, and that's like the inside of the pencil or the shavings of the pencil, and then you've got the actual lead point. So I'm just going to show you the end result because all of these are pretty self-explanatory on how to put them together. But as you can see, I've got that metallic piece at the very top of the pencil with the lead at the bottom and then the eraser at the very top. And then I'm just going to go ahead and move on to the pen. Again, very self-explanatory, just a few pieces to put together, and it looks so realistic, I can't get over it. So I'm gonna go ahead now and make the scissors, which my daughter actually did think were real scissors or actual scissors. So I cut the blades out of silver metallic cardstock, and then I used a matching dark blue cardstock for the handles. And there's a tiny circular piece that goes in the center that just sort of looks like where the screw is on the pair of scissors usually. So I'm going to go ahead and start putting together my card now. And again, my card, the actual card is going to be this shaped card base that we created before with the score line of that die. So I'm going to take the pattern piece of paper that I've cut out and use the X-Acto knife to cut the top. And I'm going to just adhere that with some double-sided tape. And then to adhere the actual clipboard mechanism, you can see on the back where the screws would be because of the detail in the actual die itself. So I'm just going to put little dots of glue to adhere that to the top, and then put this piece of blue cardstock that's going to act as my paper there right underneath and centered. And because I want to make sure that it's dead on centered, I'm going to use some liquid glue. That way I don't have to worry about being a little bit off to the left or to the right. I just wanted to make it look nice and cohesive and centered. Again, this mechanism actually does work, so that's a lot of fun, but it won't actually hold a piece of cardstock. You will need to adhere it down somehow. This is the end result, and I just love that it makes an actual shaped card base. I think that just makes it even more special. To finish it off, I used a sentiment from the stamp market that says, "Oh, happy day," and those two paperclip dies just shaped like a heart. I put them together that way, and then adhered that pencil there to the left. I just love this month's kit. I'm going to be giving this as a small gift to my daughter's teacher on her first day of school, just as a welcome back. I hope that you've enjoyed the video and learned a little bit about what you can do with your large die of the month. As always, links to all of the products and my social medias are in the description. Thank you so much. Bye.